What's going on, guys? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Summer, and today I want to talk to you guys about concentric and eccentric phases in each exercise. Now, you can incorporate eccentric and concentric phases within each exercise movement that you do, whether it's a squat, a bicep curl, or any exercise. It's going to help your training. It's going to help you get stronger, build your muscle mass, and all that stuff. But I specifically just want to talk about pull-ups and push-ups for a prime example. Now, I have to obviously teach you guys what concentric and eccentric is, and I'm just going to summarize it just a little bit. In every exercise, you're going to have two different phases. Concentric is the contraction of your muscles. So if you think of a push-up, the concentric phase of that push-up is when you are pressing up and straightening back up to that plank position at the top of the movement, and you are contracting your muscles to get there. Now, the eccentric phase is the elongation of your muscles within that specific exercise. So if you're looking at a push-up, the eccentric phase would be coming down to the floor. Now, the reason why these two phases are important, because most of the time there is only emphasis on the concentric part. If you think of a squat, you never focus on the lowering phase of the squat. If you think of a bicep curl, you're never focusing on the lowering phase of the bicep curl. We only care about getting that weight up. We only care about squatting that weight up, or we only care about pressing up out of the push-up. Same for when talking about a pull-up, you're only focusing on getting your body up, and we're not focusing on getting our body down. If you're tired of consistently doing a modified pull-up or push-up, this is a very important video for you. And I say this because if you train your eccentric and concentric within your exercise program and start nailing in the eccentric within every movement that you're doing, you're gonna get stronger, you're gonna get better, you're gonna get sore, and you're also going to stop modifying, and you'll eventually be able to get stronger and transition out of the modification. Modifications are for you to make the exercise easier in hopes that you'll build your muscle to get stronger. Now, when you think of a push-up, the modified version of a push-up is generally just getting on your knees. And although the majority of the time, if someone hasn't worked out at all and they don't really have any muscle, yes, that's a great modification for someone. But for someone maybe who has a good amount of muscle, they have been working out, they're not necessarily a beginner, and the push-up on their knees looks pretty easy for them, that's where you need to say, hey, okay, this is too easy. Push yourself and be aware and say, hey, this is too easy for me. I need to challenge myself a little bit more so I'll eventually continue to get stronger and quit modifying this push-up and be able to do it in the recommended way. Because you can only get so strong doing a push-up on your knees. And same goes for your pull-up. You can only get so strong doing the modified version of a pull-up, which is typically using the rubber band and wrapping it around your knee or your foot. If you've made it to that point where you've mastered the modified version of that specific movement, you need to start emphasizing more on the concentric and eccentric phase. When you focus on both of those phases within the exercise, you're going to gain muscle, get stronger, and be able to quit doing that modified version. So when you think of a push-up or you think of a pull-up, the eccentric phase of a push-up is coming down to the floor. Eccentric phase of a pull-up is when you're lowering yourself back down to the bottom part of that position. The reason why eccentric training is so great is because you're adding tension. So if I were to train the eccentric portion of each of those movements, I would really emphasize lowering myself slowly to the ground and then contracting my muscles and pressing out of that movement for a push-up. For a pull-up, I'm going to come up to the top of the pull-up and then I'll slowly lower myself down to the bottom of the movement. That's going to allow me to add tension when I'm working on the eccentric phase. So you're not only working on the contraction of your muscles, but you're also working on slowly lowering yourself out of that movement. We all know when you add tension to your muscle, you're going to add on your workload. When you add workload within your muscle group, that's going to increase the microscopic tears within your muscle, and that's going to equal out to more muscle regeneration. The more load on the muscle, the higher chance there's going to be at muscle mass and strength. Eccentric and concentric phases correlate together to help you increase your strength and muscle. I'm going to bring changes within those muscle fibers as well as the cross-sectional area of that muscle fiber. A combination of both is more efficient than just doing one over the other, as well as offering a lot of other health benefits. You need to continually adapt with your body. Your body is going to get used to things, and that's why if you're in a training program, it's always recommended to progressively overload. And that means just basically increasing your volume, increasing your weight, increasing your sets, increasing your reps within whatever exercise you're doing, because if you continually do the same thing that you always have been doing, there's no way for you to see progress. That being said, in training your concentric and eccentric phases, you might need to add in new exercises. You might need to add in different phases, different time under tension during your eccentric as well as your concentric phase of that exercise. You have to create added challenges for yourself, and that comes in with you being aware of how your body is able to handle these certain things. Now, the last thing that I want to say, whether you're into training eccentric or concentric and you just don't want to overthink anything that you're doing and you just want to get in and get out, you have to know that quality is obviously over quantity. So if there's 5 push-ups that you need to do in the workout, I would rather see you cutting it down to maybe 1 or 2 reps of actual good push-ups or pull-ups instead of seeing you just bang out incorrect form and not actually strengthening or adding tension onto those muscles. Now, with that being said, I have a couple clips of a push-up and a pull-up of how you can train the concentric and eccentric phases of that rep. And just remember that you can do it however you want. You can train a little bit of eccentric that day. You can train just concentric. You can basically, there's endless opportunities with whatever exercise you're doing, but just remembering that there are 2 different phases of one movement is key to doing things correctly. So with your push-up, like I mentioned, lowering your body to the floor is going to be the eccentric phase. So you can sometimes lower your body slowly to the floor. Then when you get to the bottom, if you don't have the strength to get up out of that movement, get on your knees and then press up out of the push-up, and that's your concentric phase. Now also, you can focus on just pressing up out of the movement and focusing on your concentric phase and maybe not even worrying about your eccentric phase that day. But don't think that the only way for you to get your push-up is to just do your push-ups on your knees and go as fast as you can, not have the correct form. That's not the way to do it. Focus on one thing over another. Mix and match certain things and you'll be able to build strength and build muscle. Now, same goes for your pull-up, especially if you're doing a banded pull-up. When you're using a rubber band with your pull-up, you have to remember that that's going to add extra spring for you to get the momentum to come up to the top of the movement. Common sense for you to know that there's no muscle building within that phase. To some extent, for some people, there might be just a little bit because they're not used to doing that at all. If something's adding extra spring for you to get up to the top of the movement, unless you're emphasizing on the other phase of the movement, the eccentric phase, there's no way for you to build muscle because you're just springing up and down within that movement and really not getting any tension on your muscle. So if you do use a rubber band, put it on your feet, put it on your knees, you'll come up to the top of the movement. You can even not use a rubber band and just jump up to the top of the movement. And then just slowly lower yourself down, and that would be the eccentric phase. And as you get better and better, you'll be able to add more seconds to the eccentric phase. And also, if you use a rubber band and want to focus on the concentric phase, start at the very bottom of the movement, have your arms all the way locked out, and slowly lower yourself up to add tension on the concentric phase, and then slowly lower yourself down for the eccentric phase. So there's a couple different ways you can do it. I hope this video made sense to you. I hope it helps you. If you have any questions, comment down below, give this video a like, share it, try it out, and I will catch you guys in the next video.